Well, if you think about the face of Duck Dynasty, you probably picture someone with a long, scraggly beard. But the truth is, there wouldn't be much of a show, or a family for that matter, if it wasn't for the ladies that married those beards. So joining us now from Louisiana are Corey and Jessica Robertson. It's so nice to have you with us.
Thanks for having us.
Hi, good to be here.
Talk a little bit about those beards. I'm sure everybody who watches the show says, now, when the season is over, do they ever tell their husbands time to shave?
No, we actually are the two daughter-in-laws that love the beards. We are, we married them clean shaven, and we love them that way as well. And they've got super cute dimples, but now that they have the beards, We love the beards. We're used to
you
it.
You grow fond of the beards. And I've always said, I feel like we're protected with him having a beard. When we're out in public, nobody's going to mess with him with that beard. He looks crazy.
Well, just a few years ago, your family's claim to fame was that they made a really great duck call. But now, I mean, y'all have a couple best-selling books. You've got the number one TV show on cable, and now a new Christmas album people might not know about. How have you managed the celebrity status of this and also kept your kids the way you want them to be?
Certainly, God had greater plans for us than we could have ever imagined. You know, we were excited and went into the decision to make this TV show with a lot of prayer, and we're so thankful for the success of it and the impact that it's had on the country. You know, we hear people all over the country tell us how important it is to their family and that it's family time for them and that it's gotten them back to sitting around the dinner table and praying together, and so we're super thankful to that. But for us, it's been a blessing for us as well. We have done it as a family. We're so thankful for that. You know, it's not like we go away to work. We're together all the time.
It's family support. So going into it, we got together, prayed about it, and said, is this what God would want us to do? And I think that, you know, we just keep each other, hold each other accountable. And the same with our kids. I mean, sure, maybe like Sadie probably has a little more to deal with than our young kids. Jeff and I have four young kids. But even then, nobody looks at them any differently in school. And they go to the same school together. We go to the same church. And so everybody around our town, nobody looks at us any differently, really. We don't look at either person in the family as being famous. But, you know, we keep each other grounded is basically what we do.
But talk to me a little bit about the folks in West Monroe, Louisiana, because the decision you all made as a family to embark on this really brought all kinds of outsiders and camera and video gear into West Monroe. Has the community reacted differently to you? What's it like?
I think the community has been blessed. I think businesses are doing even better now that people come in. People will come in and stay weeks at a time and just stand outside beside the deck commander office waiting to see a glimpse of somebody. And we all take turns going out and signing autographs. But everybody's so grateful. I mean, more businesses are being opened. And I think that nobody here in our hometown is you know, upset about that Dynasty.
It's become a tourist destination for sure.
It's all good. Well, people enjoy the show because of its down-home feeling and some of the values, Corey, that you talked about a little bit earlier. And I'd like to talk about what some of the ways your family, I should mention your CD is called Duck the Halls, of course. What else would you call it? But what are some of the ways that your family ducks the halls for the holidays?
Yeah, we had the best time making this album, Duck the Halls. It started this summer, so we've had like Christmas all year around here. We decorated the studio where we performed and we sang in, and we did it as a family and had a great time. And now that it's actually Christmas season, we're excited to be able to decorate our own homes, and we've started doing that. And what's really exciting to us right now with Duck the Halls is we partnered with Teleflora. And this is a great partnership because fans of our show and fans of our album can go online, go to Teleflora.com, purchase one of the bouquets that one of the Robertson wives have chosen. Yeah. We each chose a different bouquet. Purchase a bouquet, and you get a free download of the album. So it's kind of a gift to our fans to be able to have something special to decorate
their
home.
It's the gift that keeps on giving is what we say. And so, like, each one, like, I did the Send a Hug Cuddle Bear bouquet, and so any of your loved ones you want to send a hug to, It's a great, fun way to show your love to everybody. And it's great to have, you know, fresh flowers in your house. And like Corey said, we chop down our own trees and decorate it. And we love to have living, you know, it's like the men have to be out in the woods. We bring the woods into the home so that they'll stay in a little bit more during the holidays.
It really is fun to have fresh flowers and fresh cuttings from your yard and your house during the holiday season. By the way, I mentioned the album. One of the songs on here is I Can't Wait to Listen to, Camouflage and Christmas. Where did this whole album concept come from?
That's a beautiful song. Actually, Jason Missy's oldest son, Reed, sings that song, and it's an you know, it's in honor of our troops and the people that are overseas and not able to be with their families at Christmas time. We think about this, our troops, often all year round, but especially at Christmas when they're sacrificing a lot to be away from their families. But last season, our Christmas special, we sang Silent Night at the end of it, and we just got a lot of great response from people saying, you know, you should do something. You should do an album. And we all grew up singing in the church. Some of us are better singers than others. Jessica and I are the backup singers.
I sing really good in the shower. I don't know what happened. When
I'm
I heard myself on
singer.
The, like, we took individual times and, like, sang, and then we'd go listen to ourselves. I'm like, oh, God. No wonder I don't have a solo on this album.
This album's going to wind up in lots of stockings this Christmas season, I think.
It's really great. It's really well done. And, like, I was blown away by Sadie and Reed's talent. Just, I mean, we knew Missy had an amazing voice, but I think it was those, like, Willie, like, these unexpected talents that you didn't know. And even
Si.
Yes.
Yeah, Si sings the Grinch on the album and does a great job.
Yes.
And then Phil and George Strait, it's two legends together, which was really cool. When George Strait said he would be on our album and sang the song about Christmas cookies, it's perfect for Phil.
Exactly.
And, yes. So we feel like the album feels like us. It's real. It's good. And we brought in a lot of great partners, George Strait, Luke Bryan, Allison Krauss, and Josh Turner to partner with us. And you know,
and audit as a family, and even the kids, the little ones got on there. Even River 4 was in there, and Missy was trying to wrangle him and put him up to the mic. But it was so cute just doing it as a family, and that memory will stay with us forever.
Well, we're all looking forward to season 5. We just want to say thank you for being with us today. It's always fun to be with your family. You guys have a great time whenever you get together. Corey and Jessica, the Duck Dynasty divas, not really. You're really queens of the road there, queens of the house. And we want to say that their new CD is called Duck the Halls. It is a great stocking stuffer. Gals, it's been great to be with you today. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us. We'll be back
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, too. We're going to be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.